be.
The other item that occurs in our daily flag ceremony is a patriotic song. And the kindergartners have chosen Grand Old Flag. No words, please join us.
Welcome you by invitation of Mr. and Mrs. Walter. And say congratulations, students. You've done it. You've accomplished your one and only first year of school. So we're going to celebrate that accomplishment and all you've learned here. And so again, that will speak for itself. But I also congratulate the parents, because without all of you, this doesn't happen. And relatives and grandparents. So it's a team effort. And I congratulate you as well. I think this is really something, what we're doing here, what all of us together as a community and a learning community. So thank you for your support and congratulations. I do want to officially introduce key players, very key players in this year's success that we're celebrating. Mrs. Perlman's already been up here, but the Chancellor. about, not to diminish their importance, but kindergartners in PE, for example, but even ours, takes a lot of skill and trickery sometimes to pull that off. So I do want to introduce Mrs. Young in music. Please come forward. Our founders, whose idea was to start this thing, and all the energy and effort they put in, a risk they put in, still, some of them are on the governing council now. So let's see, a couple founders here, Mrs. Nunley, Mrs. Adams. So I want to acknowledge them.
Mentioned it is you. Thank you for getting homework done and supplies and
getting them to school.
Getting them to school and picking them up on time and stone soup and one potato, two potato, and all the ways that you have helped our classes. Please, a hand for yourself. Thank you. We're going to talk a little bit more about, curriculum. Here at EVCA, we do teach all of our subjects. Our day is full. We learn a lot. We start our day, we talk about our curriculum because we're very proud of it. Part of our mission statement is that we are going to teach our willing students a rigorous education. The humanities, arts, and sciences. And we do that every day. We start with math.
Okay, beginning of the day, we do use the Singapore math program. And the way that's structured is we start out with manipulative. We're just kind of learning what counting is. We have our blocks, we have our charts, we have our markers, we have all kinds of things to start just kind of working our hands and implementing that idea into our minds. And then we start going on into what we call the pictorial process. And that's taking the pictures in the books and applying what we've learned with our hands, now putting it into the books and able to writing and filling in the blanks with that. And then the final part, the third step, is the abstract. So we start moving into what symbol. What does it mean when I have this group and this group? How do I connect them together? So basically, that's what we do in the morning. We start out with calendar math, every day, adding a straw, adding a sticker, and seeing what all that looks like. We ended up with 171 yesterday. So they're good at their counting. So that's that.
After math, we do our phonics program. Any effective reading program has five components: phonics, phonemic awareness, vocabulary, fluency, and comprehension. And here at EVCA, we start with our phonics program. They learn the English language the hard way, maybe a little different than what you do. But English is hard. And A has four sounds. What are the sounds?
L-A-R-R.
And then there's this one that has six sounds. O-U-G-H, what are they? So O like in though, and oo like in through, and
now is in bow.
Oh, up as in enough? You figure it out. Oh my. But with those awareness of the phonemic sounds and phonics, we get into a phonemic awareness. And with that, the students are able to decode. They're able to start to read. And not just reading cat, but reading words like music and truly. And learning all of those sounds of the English alphabet. Once we are able to do that, we start working on vocabulary. Kindergartners learn over 300 vocabulary words in this first year of school. They practice with fluency and no longer having to chunk their sounds, they're able to read and comprehend and fluently and be able to comprehend the stories. So, wow, we started in October. We're able to pick it up. And that's our phonics program. And we are very proud of you readers. Good job.
Very good. Hey, we have a much needed lunchtime and a big break. And then we come back in the afternoon for science. In science, we are in the pursuit of knowledge about how the world is and which we live. So we ask questions about the process. How does the seed start? What's the process of the seed? We ask questions about what's the process of weather? What do we have to have for weather? So we learn, again, through hands-on, through reading stories, and making those connections in that way. So as you've seen on the videos, we learn about the human body and the senses, magnetism, weather, conservation, and recycle. How can we protect this beautiful world in which we live? We have three biographies that we learn. We learn about Wilbur and Orville. The Wright brothers, you saw them throw in the airplanes. Jane Goodall, conservationist. And George Washington Carver, who figured out how to plant a certain crop to help protect the cotton crop. So that's what our science is.
Then we teach history and geography. The students learn all of the oceans, they learn direction, they learn all the continents. Not only do they learn the continents, but they learn about an animal specific to the continent, a man-made object specific to the continent, and a food group. We have traveled to Machu Picchu and the Great Wall of China and the Eiffel Tower and, where else have we gone? The Great Pyramids of Africa, learning about these wonderful symbols of each continent of our world. We've eaten rice, bananas Foster, we've made corn tortillas. We didn't eat the eucalyptus leaves in Australia, nor did we eat the moss in Antarctica, but they were okay with that. In addition, we've learned about the presidents. Our first president. We learned about our founding fathers. We learned about the Declaration of Independence and our Constitution. We learned about the presidents that are on Mount Rushmore. Can you name them? Your kindergartners can. And of course, we've learned about a little bit about our symbols, our American symbols, the Statue of Liberty, our various symbolic flags, our flags of our country. We've gone into Mr. Knuckles' class and learned about how the flags were created and all of our American symbols. We've learned a lot.
Okay, and then wrap up our day, we do literature. We read stories and we understand the virtues and character of the characters of the different stories. The bottom of the stories are the nursery rhymes, and we don't butter them up and make them okay. There's a consequence to learn. Chicken Little. they all followed the chicken and whose head, the sky was falling. Okay, so everybody starts following them into the den because the fox had trickery. And the fox had a pretty good meal that night. So that was our consequence to understand, do we follow or should we take the lead and think for ourselves? So lots of those stories that we learned about. So we learned about the character in which we establish our hosts we want. We learn about respect, responsibility. We learn about integrity, cooperation, courage, citizenship, honesty, and perseverance. We work really hard and many of them know how to persevere. I hope you continue with great characters.
Part of our end of day is also learning about the poems and the rhymes that we grew up with, the classic versions. And each kindergartner, and I think they know them all, but they all chose a specific poem or song that they're going to share with you today. So we're going to start at this end and come all the way down to this end. And I'm going to ask if you could please hold the pause until we get through the whole line. And we'll get through it a little bit faster. Kindergartners, please stand on your spot. Sit next to your partner.
Mama, I found your shoes.
Where's your partner? Are you on your spot? Are you next to your partner? Are you on your spot?
Shumpert.
The queen of hearts, the queen of hearts, she Carly Pettingill. Bennett Webb.
Fishing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish on my 6 there, then I let it go and it finally let it go because it reminds me of pushing it and it bites this little finger on my back.
Riley Rain.
Along came a spider who sat down beside her and scared little Miss Muffet away.
Austin Dick.
Hunter Hunter, Robert Louis Stevens. The birdie with the yellow bill hopped upon my window sill. Caught her shiny eyes and you should be seen.
Trinity Toller.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here's my handle, here's my stuff. When I get up, cleaned up, hear me shout.
Philip Hernandez.
Weighing on the wing grass, weighing on the tree, weighing on the rooftop, not on me.
Jacob Sibley.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird, and if that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring, and if that diamond ring turns to brass, Papa's gonna buy you a looking glass, and if that looking glass gets broke, Papa's gonna buy you a billy goat, and if that billy goat don't pull, Papa's gonna buy you a cart and a bull, and if that cart and bull tip over, Papa's gonna buy you a dog named Rover, and if that dog named Rover don't bark, Papa's gonna buy you a horse and a cart, and if that horse and cart fall down, you'll still be the sweetest little baby in town.
Jenna Maurer.
Jack and Jill ran up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jack fell down and broke his crown, and Jill came tumbling after.
Trevor Serrano.
Jack be nimble. Jack be quick. Jack jump over the candlestick.
Otis Smith.
Fuzzy Wuzzy. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very Fuzzy Wuzzy.
Andrew Henson.
Humpty Dumpty. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. Over King Toyson and over King's men, Toy put Humpty Dumpty to devil them.
Leah Campbell.
Three blind mice. See how they run. They all ran after the farmers who cut off the tails with a carving knife. Have you ever seen such a sight in your life as three blind mice?
Alexandra Pena.
Ladybug, fly away home. Your house is on fire and your children are gone. All except one, and that's little Anne, for she has crept under the frying pan.
Landon Bauer.
There was a crooked man, walked a crooked mile. He sat a crooked sixpence against the crooked stile. He bought a crooked cat who caught a crooked mouse, and they all lived together in a little crooked house.
Fiona Mann.
Hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle. The cow jumped over the moon. The little dog laughed to see such sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon.
James Clark.
You're a grand old flag, you're a high flying flag. Forever in peace may you wave. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the brave. Every heart beats true for the red, white, and blue. There's never a post or a brag. Sure, Lord, don't quite mince, be forgot. Keep your eye on the grand old flag.
Kyle Adams.
Hickory dickory dock. Hickory dickory dock. The mouse came up the clock. Clock took one and down he ran. Hickory dickory dock.
Just give these kindergartners a They've been going to kindergarten a long time. And they've got a song to talk to you about their time. I've been going to kindergarten. One, two, three.
I've been going to kindergarten all the whole year round.
Happy faces and love and cheer. I is
imagination needs at every turn.
Thank you. there are a lot of rules. There's how to pack up, how to get the lunch, how to go to the bathroom, how to be in line, how to go down the hallway quietly, how to do the homework folders. We have lots and lots and lots of structure. It's almost like we were in the army or something. Kindergarten, attention! I don't know, but I've been told.
I don't know, but I've been told.
Kindergarten made us grow.
Kindergarten made us grow.
We learned to count, write, and read.
We learned to count, write, and read.
Raise our hands before we speak.
Raise our hands before we speak.
Sound off.
1, 2, 3, 4.
ABCs and 1, 2, 3.
ABCs and 1, 2, 3.
Good behavior got us treats.
Good behavior got us treats.
Try so hard to make you proud.
Try so hard to make you proud.
We're through with kindergarten. Shout it out.
We're through with kindergarten. Shout it out.
Okay, kindergarten, have a seat. One up, one back. One up, one back. Let's switch down. We're going
to do our next one.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oops, sorry.
I am your child.
We did practice. We really did. I got ready to go. I'll get it. This is a song that speaks to me personally because even though they're your children, they are in my heart. They really are. And I know they're in Mrs. Walter's heart as well. So this next one is a song by Barry Manilow. Okay, who of you know who Barry Manilow is? All right, okay, good, some of you. I am showing my age, I know. It's called I Am Your Child. I believe our kindergarten aides are ready with tissues. Here we go.
Yeah.
Okay, I did see a few tears.
I was gonna.
This portion of our program is talk about the. Is to talk about our two awards that are given to all to two special children in each class, and that goes all the way from kindergarten up to 12th grade. We're going to present them today.
Okay, our first award is called the High Flying Eagle Award. It goes to the student who has achieved and performed at the highest ability. This person actually came in halfway through the year for me. I was a little nervous. We just learned all of our phonograms. What am I going to do with this child? This child came in prepared. Not only did he come in prepared, he didn't get a single card mark. He was helpful to other students. He was able to share some stories. He reached out and he touched a lot of lives. So I'd like to honor William Burroughs.
Character are really stressed in our classrooms, and this particular student exhibited all of those pillars on a daily basis, being respectful, persevering, being honest, having integrity, having courage to stand up in front of people when she didn't want to. And of course, she has honesty and integrity and takes responsibility. My High Flying Eagle Award this year goes to Jenna Maurer. Let's give these two a round. The other award is the Young Lincoln Award of Excellence in Character. And we particularly look at perseverance. This is a tough thing to do, to walk into kindergarten and learn how to read when you walk out, and to follow, again, our children's character. This particular young man, when he came to kindergarten, did not know how to read. And now he's finished 60 phonics books. He's gone through all the Frog and Toad series books. He has persevered. He's gone and he's done all of the Commander Toad books, and now he's in the series of books that a second grader is normally in. To this young man, it's not about raising the bar. I don't think he thinks there is one. Congratulations, Austin Dick.
But he never gave up. He just kept improving himself to the point of becoming the president of the United States. This young man was kind of, I don't know about these phonograms, I'm not so sure about him. And then about around March or so, and he started going, shoot, I am enjoying what I am doing. All of his penmanship, everything turned around. He persevered. He saw that light. He stood up and has done a great job. So person for the Lincoln Award is Arnie Hubbard.
Let's give these kids another applause. Thank you. So in this portion of our program, our kindergarten is going to go outside. Dye your cups. They'll be called in one at a time from each classroom according to our schedule. So we need to give them a little bit of time to get ready. I do want to remind you that after our graduation, we're going to stay here for just a few minutes for pictures, and then you're invited to a reception in our classroom. So kindergarten, please stand up. We are going to be coming down.
Well, that was terrible.
Are you ready for your first grader?
Hubbard.
Alexandra Pena. Get it wet.
Ricky Wilcox.
Attention.